Hey guys, Kirky here. So much for not making videos, huh? It's been a whole 2 days. But this isn't my typical video. This is a vlog. I mean, it's not just sitting down playing a game and shooting the breeze. Although my original plan for this was I was going to have Metroid Dread running in the background with the run I did earlier tonight. That run didn't happen. That speed run did not happen. I could not get that one started. It frustrated me. So instead, I went to a save point and practiced some spots I've been having trouble with. In any case, you saw the thumbnail at this point. I don't know what it is yet, but I'm sure you guys do. On my walk today, day one of being able to go for a walk, because it's the first day in like literally almost 10 days that it hasn't rained. One other day it didn't rain about 4 days ago, except it did rain. I made it. Well, that was actually the video that I made mentioning that I was going to quit YouTube. I went on a walk that day as well, and it rained when I started on my way back home. Thankfully, it was just a light sprinkle. Awesome. But in any case, this video today is just, I just wanted to talk about this little guy, this turtle here. Just give me a second, I'll switch things around so you can actually see his pretty little face. Okay, so this turtle here, I have a fun little story about him, and I just wanted to share it. So, you can't see it along here because the sun has it bleached out, but along this section here, good, this is sort of showing my mouse, sorry for it being so small. This section along here is the road I walk, I plan on walking just about daily unless it rains, or once my uncle finally gets his wood and I can start working on that, then I'll be walking this route every other day. But on the way back through, I saw this little guy in the middle of the road, like roughly around here, except, you know, over this way off screen. And I was like, that looks like a rock. Like back in the off the distance, I thought somehow a rock must have got kicked up onto the road from the time I went that way and came back. But nope, as I got closer, I was like, oh no, that's not a rock. I recognize what that is. And at that point, I probably would have been somewhere in this little bit of a turn. Like this has a slight gradient of a turn. And on this side of the camera, the side where I'm actually standing in this picture, there's a bridge. So I saw a car coming across there, and when I realized that was a turtle and I noticed the car, I booted it for all I was worth. I did not want that poor little thing to get squished, because that's what would happen. People don't care about something like that. They would have just seen it as just a rock or something, or saw it as a turtle and veered for it. So I was like, I can't let him die. I'm going to do what I can to save him. I rushed up to him, made it. Say he was sitting here. Say this was the middle of the road. I made it to about here. My dog froze in his tracks. So, apparently my dog's terrified of turtles that are about this big. Go figure. I actually should have known that, because he's a coward of a dog. Aren't you, Spike? You don't know. You're back there sleeping. But, yeah, I rushed in. He just slammed the brakes on, like, to the point that his face was just being pulled like this when I was trying to get him to follow over. I had to leave him there. I knew he wouldn't move at that point because his eyes were fixated on that turtle. He did not know what it was. He was terrified of it. So I dropped the leash. I rushed over, grabbed the turtle, and put him, well, where you see right here. You see, I do have two pictures. This is where he started to go back the way he came. I was like, come on, friend, you don't have to go that way. I kind of felt bad because he was coming from this side with the way he was going. He was going across this way to where I think he was probably going to eventually end up, was down in under the bridge into the creek. So I took this little guy. I picked him up by the shell. I could barely grab him like this. I didn't want to grab him like this because, well, you see those claws. He's a wild animal at the end of the day. You know, he could have had rabies. Not likely, but there's an off chance. And on top of that, those claws are sharp. Very much sharp. So they can do the damage if they get those contacted on you. So I did not want to be scratched all to hell by a turtle. So I held him like this finger and this finger in under the shell part. I'm pointing as if you can see. can't see what I'm pointing at, but you get what I mean. The lip of the shell where it curls in under like that. I don't know what the leaf's about because I never gave that to him. He wasn't eating it. It's just stuck to his face for reasons. But in any case, this little guy here, I feel like I did my good deed of the day by rushing out and saving his life. Quite literally, I feel like, anyway. Got a good laugh because my dog was just terrified of it. And it kills me that I never recorded it. I could have recorded all of this live. Well, live, you know what I mean. On the spot. I always take a camera with me when I go for a walk. Normally it's just a camera to take pictures, obviously. But it was this. This here records up to 4K. It's not good. Actually, the quality's not too awful bad. I actually bought this at one point for a webcam, hoping it would work. But it has auto-adjusting light sensitivity. Or auto-adjust the light, and it just, I couldn't get it to work because it just kept brightening and darkening up depending on if I moved at all. That's neither here nor there, though, but I really regret not taking, it never even crossed my mind. I wanted to take a picture of it, and that's what I did. I placed the camera right down in front of him, probably about this far away from him, so I could get a nice, good shot of him there. And then I got the second one as he turned away. He's like, nope, I don't like this thing in my face. The fact that he was brave enough to come out of his shell while I was still there, that shows he wasn't totally afraid of me. If he would have been totally afraid of me, he would have just stayed clammed up until I left. So at first, I started to take him back over in this way. And I was like, no, I got to take him down into the creek because I think that's where he's going. And this, while he could have eventually gotten there going this way, that's not the path he was taking. He had somewheres in mind he wanted to go, and I wanted to help him at least get across this dangerous road. Especially, I don't normally go for a walk this late in the day either. This was about 5:45, I think, when I was along here. And I never take a walk that late. But I had a rough night of sleep last night. Just a lot of stuff going on in there. I went to bed at, sorry Jason Ross if you see this, about 3 a.m. He knows it. He knows what I'm referring to because it always gets a certain song stuck in his head when I say that. But from 3 a.m. I laid there and it was almost 10 a.m. by the time I got to sleep. So I went from 10 a.m. and slept till 3 p.m. because I wanted to go for a walk, and I can't go for a walk if I don't get at least a decent enough night's sleep that I can go a little while before I get a migraine. If I would have got up at, like, noon or 1, I would have been screwed for the day. I would have been with a migraine. My head hurts fairly bad right now for more than one reason, which is the other thing I wanted to get to with this. So when I took him down to the creek, I wanted to get a picture of him. So I got this opened up. I couldn't get it turned on in time. I've never seen a turtle move so damn fast. He, as soon as I placed him down on the sand, he was gone like a rocket. I swear you could see rocket boosters just coming out of his ass. He moved so fast. But once he saw that water, I could tell that's exactly where he wanted to be. He knew he'd be safe if he was there. And he took off. But I also knew he, like when I picked him back up again, he recoiled in his shell like turtles do because that's how they stay safe if they're being attacked. So when I picked him up, he recoiled in. I brought him up, looked at him like this, and he just brought his head out and then brought his feet out. It's like he knew he was safe, and that made me so happy. I'm just going to touch on this one last thing before I move on to the rest of the story. I, growing up, no secret, I love the Ninja Turtles. It made me obsessed with turtles when I was a kid. If the internet would have existed back then, you had home video, I would have been the I like turtles guy, for sure. Because I absolutely love turtles. I actually had a little guy of my own when I was probably about 7 or 8 years old. Unfortunately, Dad gave him away to my grandmother on Mom's side of the family, and he didn't live a good life. Really didn't live a good life. I would have loved to have kept him. But, yeah, I've always had a thing for turtles. I've always loved turtles. And in my 39 years on this planet, in this place, I've only seen one turtle alive. and it's been this guy. I've seen a few that's been run over, which always just breaks my heart because, well, turtles are, to me anyway, they're a pretty animal. And if they're making it to, like, this is probably the second biggest turtle I've seen. I've seen two turtles alive, technically, now I think about it. There was one that, when I was fishing with my father, me, my father, a couple of my friends, we were out on the back roads, we'll call them. That's not what they're called, but that's what we'll call them for this video. We were out fishing and driving along one of the roads. We saw this big thing. It was literally about like this. I'm not fitting fully in this screen. Just give me a sec. There we go. This isn't perfect because I'm not centered, but when I crop it, this is where I have to sit. But that turtle, no joke, was like this. Hands, I put them like this so they look centered to you. They're, my palms are at my face at this point. But it was like this big, well over a foot big, about like yay thick. He was a chunky boy. I actually think we have a picture of that around here somewhere as well. Maybe. Man, I wanted to get out and go over to that turtle so bad, but he would have been the type one, if you would have got near him, he probably could have bit your finger off if you wasn't careful. I would have picked him up. But back to this story. I took this turtle. Once again, give me half a second to swap things around, because guess what? Doing it like this, real time, with OBS, is kind of slow, especially because it's on the other screen and I can't read that crap for crap. I need glasses. Can't afford glasses. Debt. But this guy here, I took him down to the creek, as I said, set him down, and he took off like a bottle rocket. He was out of my sight in the water in probably 4 seconds flat. Like, he went out there 20 feet easily within just a few seconds. I have never seen a turtle move that fast before, land or water. Actually, I think that's probably the first turtle I've ever seen in the water. In any case, on the way back out, like, the dog went down in there with me. He was keeping his distance, though. He would, I had the plague as far as he was concerned. He would not come near me when I had that turtle in my hands. I tried to put it near him. He took off. He wanted nothing to do with that turtle, which is why I regret so much not having this out recording the whole time. This needed to be recording. It really did, and I apologize for not doing it. But on my way back out, I was looking down, talking to the dog, and then I heard a toom. I almost laid myself out. So, like I said, I took the turtle under the bridge, and because I was looking down, I wasn't paying attention. You might be able to see it. I'll actually switch it back again. Give me half a second, guys. Actually, this might help you see it a little better with the sides like this. So right here, you can see a red mark. Well, it's about this wide across, so a couple inches wide. Sticks up about that far. I kind of cracked my head on the bottom of the bridge, so straight across the steel girder. It hit me here because I was looking down at the dog, not paying attention. If I would have been like facing forward, it probably would have taken me right over the left eye and busted me open. This is the second time I've taken head trauma in the last 9 years. July, by the way, July 22nd will make 9 years since I had the accident in the woods where a tree fell and hit me pretty much where this did, right along here and up here, which I still believe is the result of the migraines, because that's when the near daily what the doctor classes as migraines, because apparently I didn't know until I got home reading it. He asked me to describe where the pain was, and I told him the pain's like here and back in this way, and he said, yep, that's migraines, and I've had them ever since that happened. So there's no damage to my brain, so I don't know what caused that to be the trigger, but that to me is the trigger. In any case, like I said, I nearly knocked myself out. When I hit that, I heard that very distinct tong that I heard when the tree hit me all those years ago. That's a sound in my head I will never forget. Almost, it's literally your bell has been rung. And I felt my legs just lose all power, and I started stumbling back real bad. my right eye in particular, my vision was just going dark. I was pretty sure I was on the verge of passing out. And when I started stumbling back, I tried so hard to get my legs back under me to catch myself. That brought me back out of it to realize what I was doing. And I saw where I was going to land. If I wouldn't have let myself fall, I was going to go back head first into a concrete wall or concrete structure that the bridge sets on. So I had to just stop trying to catch myself and just fall. Because if I would have stepped back like 3 feet more, probably, I would have definitely cracked the back of my skull off of that concrete. So yeah, I just let myself fall back and I rolled so I wouldn't hit that. So even though it damn near knocked me out, it was to the point that I was still aware enough to know what was happening. Oh man, getting back home, it slowed me down a lot. So from where I was to home should have been about a 10-minute walk. It took me 25 minutes. Because for about 3/4 of the walk back, my legs, I was on rubber legs. My legs were just wobbly. Apologies for that, cat hair. My legs were wobbly. I was stumbling fairly bad. So there was a couple times, especially when I stepped over to the mailbox, I got the mail. And I had to put my hand on the big mail community mailbox so I didn't fall, because my legs, I was all over the place like that. Thankfully, no signs of a concussion yet. Trust me, I know what a concussion's like. I had a really severe one. And that's the thing I was worried about too, because if you've had a concussion once, repeat concussions are easier to happen. And that was a hit that could have given me a concussion easily. I'm still not out of the woods. The signs could, or the symptoms could show up within the next couple days. So I'm going to have to keep an eye on myself, like getting dizzy spells if I get up fast or move. My eyes having trouble focusing, like if everything just starts going blurry for no reason. What are a couple of the other big ones? Oh yeah, the other big one is nausea. And I've had no signs of any of it so far. Rubber legs isn't a sign of it. It's just that's something that happens when you kind of almost knock yourself out. But yeah, in any case, that's the main thing I wanted to talk about today. I'm going to switch back over to Turtle McGee here. That's the wrong one. There we are. If you guys had a chance to name this guy, what would you name him? I don't know why, but to me, he looks like a Mortimer. And I don't even know if it's a male. I think it tried to pee on me. I'm almost certain it tried to pee on me at one point. And the last tidbit about that turtle, it was covered in ants. I don't know why it had so many ants on it. But they're probably all dead now, because they would have went into the water with them and they weren't making it back to shore. So yay, I hate ants. I love to see that happen to them. Terrible, I know, but yeah, what would you name them? For me, definitely a Mortimer. Don't know why. In any case, I'm going to wrap this video up here. I've probably talked for like 40 minutes because I always prattle on for too long in these. I don't know when this will be uploaded. It's currently, well, if my watch decides it wants to turn on, it is currently the 22nd, 1:53 a.m. So the day's just rolled over. I've soon got to go to bed. Even with the YouTube thing out of the way for a little while, I don't have enough time in my day to do anything. Especially when I don't get to bed till 10 a.m. because my mind just would not stop racing. Hopefully that'll get better. In any case, look forward to seeing this whenever you see it. I'm not editing it tonight and putting it up tonight because it's too late for that. Maybe I'll do it on the next rainy day. Who knows? Oh, it's probably... Actually, when I last checked the weather, it's not supposed to rain at all this week, so... It'll get uploaded when it gets uploaded. And in any case, see you guys later. And thanks for sticking around, even through these dry times. And by dry times, I mean times without me putting any content up. If you do want to support the channel, though, check out these videos off to the side. I'm not going to complain. Later.